ورحمة الله وبركاته. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد، we commence by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sending blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask the Almighty to bless him and his entire household, those who supported him from day one. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless all his companions as well as every single one of us and our offspring to come up to the day of Qiyamah, not forgetting those who have struggled and strove through the years in order to preserve this deen in a way that today it has come to us. May Allah use us to do the same for the future generations. An Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: إن الله لا ينظر إلى أجسادكم ولا إلى صوركم ولكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم. Narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Allah does not look upon your bodies and faces, but He looks into your hearts. Beloved brothers and friends in Islam, in this competition, we will be talking about the purification of the soul. The believer, as you know, is only successful if he develops his link with his Maker and cleanses his heart. We refer to the heart, we refer to the soul. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about cleansing oneself from the sins that are apparent as well as those that are hidden. So in the Quran he says, وَضَرُوا ظَاهِرَ الْإِثْمِ وَبَاطِنَهُ, you and abandon all sins, whether they are outward or inward. And I am sure we all know that the outward sins are quite clear for everyone to see. Those which are inside are completely invisible to the rest. It is only through interaction that some of them can be picked up, and sometimes even with interaction, some of these sins cannot be picked up. So it is up to us to purify not only the soul but the heart. Knowing that some of the scholars refer to the heart and soul using the same term and some have separated the two. If the heart is pure and good, the whole body will be pure and good. What we do need to understand is that the heart is described in hadith of halal and haram, which appears in Sahih Muslim, narrated by Al-Nu'man ibn Bashir radiyallahu anhu, إِنَّ الْحَلَالَ بَيِّنٌ وَإِنَّ الْحَرَامَ بَيِّنٌ وَبَيْنَهُمَا أُمُورٌ مُشْتَبِهَاتٌ لَا يَعْلَمُهُنَّ كَثِيرٌ مِّنَ النَّاسِ. Halal is quite clear and haram is also quite clear. And between the two, there may be a gray area where people maybe do not know is the halal or is the haram. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.